Send out your light and your truth, that they may lead me and bring me to your holy hill and to your dwelling. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, who have erred and strayed from your ways of mercy, we have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for our sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. In the Lord's name be praised. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the depths of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness, when your fathers tested me and put me to the proof, though they had seen my works. 40 years long was I grieved with this generation, and said, it is a people that earn their hearts. They have not known my ways, of whom I swore my wrath, that they should not enter into my rest. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. O come, let us adore him. I will magnify you, O Lord, for you have lifted me up and have not let my foes triumph over me. O Lord, my God, I cried unto you, and you have made me whole. You, Lord, have brought my soul out of the grave. You have saved my life from among those who go down to the pit. Sing praises unto the Lord, O you saints of his, and give thanks unto him for the remembrance of his holiness. For his wrath endures but the twinkling of the eye. His pleasure for a lifetime. Heaviness may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. In my prosperity I said, I shall never be moved. You, Lord, of your goodness, have made my hill so strong. You turned your face from me, and I was distressed. Then I cried unto you, O Lord, and came to my Lord most humbly. What profit is there in my bloodshed if I go down into the pit? Shall the dust give thanks unto you, or shall it declare your faithfulness? Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. O Lord, be my helper. You have turned my lamentation into dancing. You have put off my sackcloth and girded me with gladness. Therefore shall my heart sing of your praise without ceasing. O Lord, my God, I will give thanks unto you forever. In you, O Lord, have I put my trust. Let me never be put to confusion, Deliver me in your righteousness. Bow down your ear to me and make haste to deliver me, and be my strong rock and house of defense, that you may save me. For you are my strong rock and my castle. Be also my God and lead me for your name's sake. Draw me out of the net that they have laid secretly for me, for you are my strength. Into your hands I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me, O Lord, O God of truth. I have hated those who hold to worthless vanities, and my trust has been in the Lord. I will be glad and rejoice in your mercy, for you have considered my trouble and have known my soul in adversities. You have not shut me up in the hand of the enemy, but have set my feet where they may walk at liberty. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with heaviness, and also my soul and my body, for my life has grown old with heaviness, and my years with mourning. My strength fails me because of my iniquity, and my bones are consumed. I have become a reproof among all my enemies, but especially among my neighbors. My acquaintances are afraid of me, and those who see me in the streets shrink from me. I am utterly forgotten as a dead man out of mind. I have become like a broken vessel. For I have heard the whispering of the multitude, and fear is on every side, while they conspire against me and take their counsel to take away my life. But my hope has been in you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God. My time is in your hand. Deliver me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me. Show your servant the light of your countenance, and save me for your mercy's sake. Let me not be confounded, O Lord, for I have called upon you. Let the ungodly be put to confusion and be put to silence in the grave. Let the lying lips be put to silence, which cruelly, disdainfully, and despitefully speak against the righteous. Oh, how plentiful is your goodness, which you have laid up for those who fear you, and which you have prepared for those who put their trust in you. Even before the children of men, you hide them in the secret place of your presence from those who conspire against them. You keep them in your refuge from the strife of tongues. Thanks be to the Lord, for he has shown me marvelously great acts, great kindness in a strong city. But when I was afraid, I said in my haste, I am cast out of the sight of your eyes. Nevertheless, you heard the voice of my prayer when I cried unto you. O love the Lord, all you his saints, for the Lord preserves those who are faithful, and plenteously repays the proud. Be strong, and he shall establish your heart, all you that put your trust in the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Ruth, beginning with the first chapter, the first verse. Now it came about in the days when the judges governed that there was a famine in the land, and a man of Bethlehem in Judah went to reside in the land of Moab with his wife and his two sons. The name of the man was Elimelech, and the name of his wife Naomi, and the names of his two sons were Mahlon and Chilion, Ephrathites of Bethlehem in Judah. So they entered the land of Moab and remained there. Then Elimelech, Naomi's husband, died, and she was left with her two sons. And they took for themselves Moabite women as wives. The name of the one was Orpah, and the name of the other Ruth. And they lived there about 10 years. Then both Mahlon and Chilion also died, and the women. And the woman was left without her two sons and her husband. Then she arose with her daughters-in-law to return to the land of Moab, because she had heard in the land of Moab that the Lord had visited his people by giving them food. So she departed from the place where she was, and her two daughters-in-law with her. And they went on the way to return to the land of Judah. But Naomi said to her two daughters-in-law, "Go, return each of you to your mother's house. May the Lord deal kindly with you as you have dealt with the dead and with me. May the Lord grant that you may find a place of rest, each one in the house of her husband." Then she kissed them, and they raised their voices and wept. However, they said to her, "No, but we will return with you to your people." But Naomi said, "Return, my daughters, why should you go with me? Do I still have sons in my womb that they may be your husbands? Return, my daughters, go, for I am too old to have a husband, if I said I have hope. If I were even to have a husband tonight and also give birth to sons, would you therefore wait until they were grown? Would you therefore refrain from marrying? No, my daughters, for it is much more bitter for me than for you, because the hand of the Lord has come out against me." They raised their voices and wept again, and Orpah kissed her mother-in-law, but Ruth clung to her. Then she said, "Behold, your sister-in-law goes back to her people and her gods. Return after your sister-in-law." But Ruth said, "Do not plead with me to leave you or to turn back from following you. For where you go, I will go, and where you sleep, I will sleep. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord do so to me, and worse if anything but death separates me from you." When she saw that she was determined to go with her, she stopped speaking to her about it. So they both went on until they came to Bethlehem. And when they had come to Bethlehem, all the city was stirred because of them, and the women said, "Is this Naomi?" But she said to them, "Do not call me Naomi, but call me Mara, for the Almighty has dealt very bitterly with me. I went away full, but the Lord has brought me back empty. Why do you call me Naomi, since the Lord has testified against me and the Almighty has afflicted me?" So Naomi returned, and with her Ruth the Moabitess, her daughter-in-law, who returned from the land of Moab. And they came to Bethlehem at the beginning of barley harvest. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted. The horse and his rider he has hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my savior. This is my God, and I will praise him, the God of my people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior, the Lord is his name. The chariots of fire and his army has he hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. The fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. He sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might. Your right hand, O Lord, has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, and work of wonders? You stretch forth your right hand, the earth swallowed them up. With your constant love, you led the people you redeemed. You brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You will bring them in and plant them on the mountain of your possession, the resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord. The sanctuary, O Lord, that your hand has established, the Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from St. Paul's first epistle to the Corinthians, beginning with the 6th chapter, the 1st verse. Does any one of you, when he has a case against his neighbor, dare to go to law before the unrighteous and not before the saints? Or do you not know that the saints will judge the world? If the world is judged by you, are you not competent to form the smallest law courts? Do you not know that we will judge angels? How much more matters of this life? So if you have law courts dealing with matters of this life, do you appoint them as judges who are of no account in the church? I say this to your shame. Is it so that there is not among you anyone wise who will be able to decide between his brothers and sisters? But brother goes to law with brother, and that before unbelievers. Actually, then, it is already a defeat for you that you have lawsuits with one another. Why not rather suffer the wrong? Why not rather be defrauded? On the contrary, you yourselves do wrong and defraud. And this is your, and this to your brothers and sisters. Or do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived, neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor homosexuals, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor those habitually drunk, nor verbal abusers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. Such were some of you, but you were washed, but you were sanctified, but you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, in the Spirit of our God. All things are permitted for me, but not all things are of benefit. All things are permitted for me, but I will not be mastered by anything. Food is for the stomach, and the stomach is for food. However, God will do away with both of them. But the body is not for sexual immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord is for the body. Now God has not only raised the Lord, but has also raised us up through his power. Do you not know that your bodies are parts of Christ? Shall I then take away the parts of Christ and make them parts of a prostitute? Far from it. Or do you not know that the one who joins himself to a prostitute is one body with her? For he says, the two shall become one flesh, but the one who joins himself to the Lord is one spirit with him. Flee sexual immorality. Every other sin that a person commits is outside the body, But the sexually immoral person sins against his own body. Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been bought for a price. Therefore glorify God in your body. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, he was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Thursday. O God, your never-failing providence sets in order all things both in heaven and on earth. Put away from us all hurtful things and give us those things that are profitable for us through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you so to guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of our life we may not forget you, but may remember that we are ever walking in your sight through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hardwood of the cross, that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. Bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you. And you promised through your well beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit.